Honey Heart C.
It is painting time! Woo! Okay, today I'm gonna be painting a super duper awesome, awesome, beautiful horse. Oh yes, it is totally, totally horse painting time. Okay, as you can see, this horse painting kit right here.
Perfect paint pals!
Okay, it's this awesome little horse play kit where you can actually paint beautiful, beautiful horses. Look how crazy colorful the box is. Comes with a blank horse. It also comes with a whole bunch of horse colored paint pots right there. And says on the back, whoop, it actually says it comes with 3 paintbrushes, so I guess if you wanted to use a different brush for a different paint pot, you could. So let's get started in this super fun do-it-yourself little model horse painting kit. Come on out. Okay, so cool. So I've never ever seen this model brand before. So this one is brand new to me. Looks like a pretty cool little model that's kind of doing like a little rear. Boop, 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 clip, clip, clip. Whoops, swing that leg out and clip. Woo! All right, so here is the awesome, awesome model that's completely blank. There's no paint on this model at all. Really cool little hard plastic body, but the mane and tail are actually a little bit softer. There's still a hard plastic, but it's a different plastic. I guess it's like, this is hollow, this is solid. Oh, I'm so excited. I'm so excited to be painting this horse.
Aw, look at all the little swirly-whirlies in the tail.
Very cute little semi-rearing. Or maybe she's just kind of in a gallop pose, kind of like about ready to just start running. Very cute. So let's get started. Here's the little paintbrushes. So you get 3 of them, but I'm only gonna use 1 of them. Whoop, little paintbrush. Now this definitely is one of those little plastic bristle ones, so these ones are usually not the best to paint with, but we will see how I do. And the paint pots, which have 6 different horsey kind of colors with white, black, brown, kind of have like a red kind of corally color, this super sunny yellow, and orange. So I'm gonna protect my work surface, whoop, and I have some clean water. Now I think I'm going to paint this beautiful horse a Appaloosa coloring, just like this gorgeous, gorgeous leopard Appaloosa. So the first thing I'm gonna do is open up the white acrylic paint. Whoop, there we go. Now if you wanted to, because the horse's base coat is gonna be white, you could just start painting spots on the horse already, but I personally like having a white paint coat go on over the plastic. You know, it's just me, what I personally like. Ba-ba-ba. Ooh man, I hope I have enough paint for this. Dip it in some water. Now the paint will go on just a little bit smoother. Because if I use too much paint, it's gonna create like these little streakies. See that streak just like that? It's just kind of a little bit too streaky. So I need the perfect balance of paint and water. I'm just going to paint the model, which I don't know. I hope I don't run out of paint doing this. Very, very possible I will. Ooh, I don't know about this. So you can kind of see just how thin these acrylic paints are. You can see what it looks like if I don't water it down. It gets real streaky looking, and that's exactly what I don't want. I want it to be real smooth. See how the water smooths it out? That's more about what I'm looking for. I have no idea how this is going to turn out. Keep that paint nice and smooth. So you can see just how thin this paint is. Whenever I take a whole bunch on my brush and I try to paint over these numbers on the bottom, you can still really see them, and you can see that the brush just kind of, it actually wipes it away. So it's not the best brush, not the best paints, but we are making it work, 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 work. All right, I've used about half of my white up, but the horse has been totally, totally painted in white here. So maybe now this next layer will look a little bit better. Kind of smooth that coat out. Normally you want to do like 2 coats to kind of coat it and prime it, but probably not gonna have enough paint to do that. And I don't wanna use up all of my white because I'm gonna need it to create the hoof color. Okay, that second coat of white is all painted on. Now the fun part, to make this horse look like an Appaloosa. Okay, so I'm gonna open up my black paint. Ba-ba-ba. Woo! I'm gonna take my paintbrush and I'm going to kind of just fray it out since I've got 3 of them, like that. Okay, perfect. I'm gonna dip my paintbrush in the paint and in a little bit of some water, just a little bit. And I'm gonna create some Appaloosa speckle splatters. So I'm just gonna do a little practice here. Ooh, to make sure I like how it's splattering. There we go. And now I'm just going to splatter these speckles on to create an Appaloosa. Look how simple and easy that is. A little bit more paint. Maybe a little bit more right here. Looks pretty good. Turn the horse around. And splatter paint. Ooh, kind of a lot there. Perfect. And of course, I don't want to forget about the front. You can do it any way you want. There is no wrong way. Get that inside leg. Get that belly. Now I'm gonna take my paintbrush, flip it upside down, take a little bit of some paint, and now I can kind of create my own Appaloosa spots, kind of anywhere I want on this horse that are a little bit bigger. Just for a little bit more detail. Now, just like Siberica, I'm gonna give this mare a great mane and tail. So I'm gonna take some of these paints, take some white, mix it with some black, and of course with some water. All right, now I'm gonna paint her tail in this gray color. I'll slowly add some more white in to kind of blend it, mixing some black in as we get kind of closer to the bottom. Don't forget the other side. And paint the mane. So I'm taking some black, mixing in some white to make this beautiful gray color.
So super duper pretty.
All right, now that the first coat on her mane and tail are dry, I'm gonna add in a second coat, just so it doesn't look so splotchy, so it has a little bit more color to it.
Do, 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 do.
Here we go. Now to paint the horse's eye, I'm gonna take my black and on the other side of my paintbrush, dip it in and just paint in the horse's eye.
Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba.
It's kind of hard to get really in there, but just keep dipping in the paintbrush in the paint, and there we go.
Aww.
Here is your eye. So let's add a little dimension to these eyes. I'll open up the brown. Ah! Oh no! It's super duper drippy. Ooh, I'll just use a little bit on my paintbrush here. And right in the middle of the horse's eye, I'm going to put some brown. While I'm waiting for that brown in the eye to dry, I'm gonna go back to my white paint and just add in a few little more white little streaks just to add in some more color detail onto the mane and tail. And now, right on top of the brown, I have a little black on my paintbrush. Just do a little tiny boop, just for the eyes. Perfect! Now to create some pinking for her nose, I'm gonna open up my red and my white. Take a little bit of some red. It's kind of a corally color with a little bit of my white. Mix it together. Really water it down so I have a very, very watery paintbrush. And I'm going to put on some of this pink. So she's got a pink little muzzle. So I had to really work that water because it's pretty watery here. And I don't want it to be too much. So I'm gonna dip my paintbrush on a little bit of a paper towel to help pick up some of that water. There we go. Now you can really see that pink muzzle. Maybe a little pink in the ears.
Ba-ba-ba.
And a tiny touch of pink for her belly.
La-da-da.
Now I'm gonna open the brown back up, take a whole bunch of white with a little touch of brown, and I'm gonna make a hoof color.
Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba.
And I will just paint her hoofs in with this kind of naturally kind of color.
Ba-ba-ba-do-do-do-do-do.
Just let it glide on to create that natural hoof shape. Whoop! Trotting on in. Oh, look at how beautiful she is, you guys. She turned out so perfect. Okay, that splatter technique makes like the perfect looking little Appaloosa speckles. And look at her eyes. Can you see just how detailed they are? Very, very cool. And of course, with the light little pinking on her nose and her hooves. Now the paint kind of kept moving and stuff, so it's just a little bit splotchy there. So I may have to go over with a third coat of paint. But other than that, she is so cute and so pretty. So totally cool little paint. Paint yourself a gorgeous model kit. Very, very happy. I hope you minis enjoyed this video. Speckly gallopy on over to my next video, and I will see you there. Bye, minis! Alright, minis, how well were you paying attention to the video? How many colors did I use to paint this Appaloosa's eyes? Do you remember?